Good morning, friends. Welcome you all to the 13th edition of Knowledge Day. During this Knowledge Day, we had a team of 10 members, and at the outset, let me thank my team who has worked to put this menu forth in this forum. Give a big round of applause to the Knowledge Day team, Mr. Harish Garware, Dr. Vijay Makhija, Dr. Manjunath, Dr. Dinesh Bhosle, Dr. P.S. Mahesh, Dr. Shri Rajesh Rosia, Dr. Ajit Ranade, Dr. Shivaji Day. So all together, we have taken almost 7 topics to be deliberated today, which are the most recent topics. And the theme for today's Knowledge Day is Igniting Minds. If a little spark can be given, which can turn into a ray of hope and finally can bloom, is our motto. In real sense, this year is a year of happenings for animal husbandry sector, which has created a history. The very first being cited as a ministry in the Government of India, the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying. And it's a big step in the history of this country that animal husbandry has been recognized up to that stage to set up an independent ministry. The second one, amongst us, our beloved Dr. G. Ranjit Reddy has been elected as Member of Parliament, Lok Sabha. A big round of applause to Dr. Ranjit Reddy, who rose the voice of poultry, his very first address in the Parliament, which is still in our mindset, and it was so vibrant that the entire fraternity that was thinking of, yes, now our voice is there in the parliament, and in a time to come, we may have many more policy interventions. So thank you very much, Dr. Ranjit Reddy, for raising the voice of poultry. And really, we wish you to see you as a member of Standing Parliamentary Committee on Animal Husbandry Sector. So all the best for that. And really, we wish to have you in the Standing Parliamentary Committee too. Friends, it's a time to think of how our sector can join the national economy and also to combat with the malnutrition. If we'll see the national statistics, more than 3 crores of children are malnourished in this country. And 50% of the death in children is because of malnutrition. This poultry can come as a tool for this combating malnutrition, as well in safeguarding the human health in a time to come. In last 10 years, it was a very slow progress so far the nutritional status improvement of human beings in this country is concerned. The NFHS statistics in 2003-05 and then 2013-14 has shown only an improvement of 5-7%. So again, giving us a challenge. But yes, a ray of hope is there. Our food habits are changing. And a recent study says that the children or the youth ranging between the age 8-17, almost 75% of them are non-vegetarian. So again, we have a lot more scope of our poultry and poultry products in a national building process. Yes, of course, as in the last Poultry Knowledge Day, we discussed that we are the third largest producer of egg in the world, and at any point of time, we may cross this to become the second one. I'm happy to share with you that already we have touched a figure of around 95 billion pieces. So this is an encouraging result. In spite of all the odds, all odd situations, we are continuing to grow at a constant growth rate. Now again, there are few points which I bring it to the notice of this August gathering. Yes, whatever we are producing, ultimately a very meager amount of the product like poultry or egg enters into an international trade. If you'll see the world or the global trade, almost 1,400 billion eggs which are produced world around, only around 11% of that enters into an international trade. But if you'll see India, around 3 to 4%. So it's a point to ponder whether we can improve this. And likewise, in broiler production or poultry meat production, also, whatever is being produced world over, around 6.8% to 10% enters into an international trade. But in India, again, we have a chunk of only 3.8%. Now, as already Mr. Anil Dhumal has stated, apprised that we do have a long and very many challenges nowadays. Wherever we are moving forward, there are challenges which we should combat successfully to keep our pace continuous. And very important challenge is increasing feed price nowadays. Yes, of course, in poultry, wherein the total production cost, around 70% accounts for feed only, and where the maize and soya prices are going very high, it is very, very difficult to be competitive into the market. Yes, of course, government has taken some steps like allowing import of maize, but still, it is a peanut for the sector as our sectorial demand is increasing day by day. Another one is cage ban issue. With this issue, we are combating since last 2 years, but yet any outcome is yet to be awaited. To some extent, we have won over the situation as now the government is in a position to regulate it. And of course, again, it's a happy note that the animal welfare issues, which were the domain of Ministry of Environment and Forest, during current year, it has been transferred to the Animal Husbandry, Fishery and Dairy Development Ministry. So now our own ministry is going to look after the animal welfare issues. So cage ban, I think we are quite hopeful that in a time to come, we'll successfully deal with the subject. AMR issues, time and again, they keep bothering our minds. But in a time to come, slowly and slowly, we shall try to overcome this. And yes, of course, which is very important, that was reducing the import duty on our chicken legs, so which has created almost sleepless night for our poultry sector for about 3 to 4 months. But with the common efforts and with the efforts of our Honorable Member of Parliament, under his dynamic leadership, the industry went to the ministries, and not only a single ministry, but a group of ministries, including Commerce Ministry. And then finally, the Niti Aayog has also supported our industry. So it's a happy moment for us that, yes, in a national interest, all the ministries are one, and definitely they are going to keep the interest of poultry industry intact. Looking for the way forward, as in today's Knowledge Day, we have kept the different technical topics like the leg weaknesses, like the recent feed milling technology, the artificial intelligence, the common and emerging and re-emerging respiratory diseases of poultry, and of course, another feather on the cap of industry is Mr. Suresh Raidu Chitturi has been elected as the chairman, International Egg Commission. So he's also going to speak on the goodness of egg today with you. As we all are aware that every year the poultry sector is under stress, and this stress is very frequent. Time and again, we are facing the challenges and the stress. So today, especially for the poultry sector, we try to invite Mr. Chetan Bhagat, who is said to be the stress reliever for ups and downs. So in the late evening, he'll be here with us to join us for a motivational speech to keep our morale high and also to tell us how to keep alleviating and mitigating this often pressure of stress in the poultry sector. So, dear friends, I'll not take much time, and now putting forth the Knowledge Day, which really starts from now. And very first, we have an honor to have Dr. G. Ranjit Reddy here as a keynote speaker, who has taken all the pains, because we all are aware that Parliament is on, and this is a very difficult for time for a parliamentarian to come out, but he has kept his promise. He is our beloved Member of Parliament. So finally, he has decided to be with us, to talk to us with the recent happenings at Delhi. So a big round of applause for Dr. G. Ranjit Reddy. Thank you. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.